Just believe the Lord for you. Believe the Lord. If God did it for Ruth, he will do it for you. I say, if God did it for Ruth, he will do it for you. What is it that you are asking? What is it that you think is impossible to be done for you by the Lord? A woman that has no future, a woman that had no direction, a woman that lost her husband, a woman that was told to go back to her father's house, just like Tamar was told to go back to your father's house and remain there. Hallelujah. And from there, God visited her. God turned the life of Ruth around. God is about to turn your life around. I say he's about to turn your life around. What is it that you think is impossible that God cannot change, God cannot do, God cannot handle? Believe him. I say believe him. The time has come for you. I say the time has come for you for a turnaround. I say your life is turning around. I say your life is turning around. Your life is turning around. I say your life is shifting. It's shifting from Moab to Judah. God is transforming you. I say it's clearing the way for you. It's clearing the way for you. Thou what held you then will no longer hold you again. I say will no longer hold you again. He sees your heart. He knows your heart. He understands what is going on. He knows how you will come out of it. Ruth came out. I say Ruth came out. What is it? What is it that is standing before you? Is it sickness? What is it that's standing before you? Holy Kaliba. What is it? Naomi had to prepare Ruth. Naomi prepared Ruth. Knowing the law, knowing the commandment, knowing that Ruth had a future, even though she didn't tell her. It was Naomi that prepared her and told her to go and meet Boaz. Sleep beside Boaz. Raise the garment of Boaz and sleep beside him. And if he asks you, tell him that you are here for inheritance. That he needs to redeem you. What he never knew. She had no idea about it. But Boaz knows the law. May God grant you a fulfillment. May he grant you a fulfillment. That all your labor will never be in vain. All your prayers will never be in vain. All you are waiting will never be in vain. May that what you've been doing for others, as Ruth did for Naomi, may it never be in vain. As he said, as she said, anywhere you go, I will be. Wherever you stop, I will stop. Your people will be my people. Your God, my God. I don't care the God I've been serving. I want to serve your own God. Talking to a woman that lost the husband, lost her children, lost everything. Jesus. Lift your hands up.
1, 2, 3.
Oh, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Father. Remember all. How he delivered you. How he saved you. How he protected you. Jesus. Yes, Lord. It is coming. It is coming. More is coming. Doors are opening. Yes, Lord. Glory. Because of what you are doing for the Lord, without knowing, reward is coming. Ruth never knew that he would end up not just marrying Boaz, not just marrying a rich man, but producing Obed, who produced Jesse, who produced David, who produced Jesus. Glory. Oh, yes, Lord. Glory. Oh, yes, Father. Glory. Jesus. If he did it for Ruth, he will do it for you. That dreams you've been having, dreams of breakthrough, dreams of healing, dreams of deliverance, dreams of elevation, they are all coming to pass. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Glory. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. You haven't seen anything yet. Major doors are about to open for you. More is coming. Greater is coming. Jesus. Jesus, glory.